Hey everyone, Tristan back with another video, and in this video I wanted to talk about helmets, specifically for e-bikes and e-scooters. Now we're kind of in a new realm where e-scooters and e-bikes and even like electronic unicycles are becoming more and more popular, and this is a new category of transportation for people. It's called PEV. PEV stands for personal electric vehicles. And your traditional bike helmet like this unfortunately is not protective enough because you're going at higher speeds with an e-bike. So this is a great helmet. It's a Bon Traeger Solstice bike helmet, and it's fully MIPS certified, and MIPS is the bike standard or cycling standard, and you can see the MIPS insignia there. But this helmet only protects up to 15 miles per hour. It's only certified for 15 miles an hour, and that's the average that bicyclists tend to go. Of course, you can go faster if you're going downhill and stuff like that, but they rate these things on averages. But your average e-bike can go a lot faster than just 15. Class 3 e-bikes can actually go up to 28 miles an hour. So oftentimes you're cruising between like 20 and 30 on an e-bike. So your traditional bike helmet is not protective enough for that. Let me show you a helmet that is, though. This is a new helmet that recently came on the market. It's by Xnito, X-N-I-T-O. And it is specifically rated for e-bikes and things like e-scooters at class 3 e-bike speed, which is 28 miles per hour. It's specifically formulated for that. So this is a really good helmet, and also one of the things I like about this one is it has a light on it as well. So it has a front light to help help people see you at night, but then it also has a backlight built in that's blinking, and then you can also change this. So this is blinking and then solid, and then it kind of glows like that. It kind of goes around. Now it's not real dark in this room, but I can tell you that these lights are really pretty bright, especially at night. And then you can turn it off. It's got a USB charger right here. So this helmet is good for e-bikes and also e-scooters. Again, it's rated for up to 28 miles per hour. And that's kind of an average. Sometimes on e-bikes and e-scooters, you can go a little bit faster in bursts and stuff like that. But in general, as I mentioned, these go by averages. It also comes with this built-in visor, which I like. You don't have to have that on. It just kind of Velcros in there, but I like because it helps with the sun. Let me go ahead and put this on and you can kind of see what it looks like. All right, so this is what it looks like on, and I have to say it's really comfortable. I mean, it just, the way that it kind of hugs your head. You also got an adjustment in the back here that you can turn to adjust it to your head size. And then this can also kind of go down like that too, if you prefer that kind of look. I mean, yeah, it's a little bit big. It's bigger than, in terms of thickness, than some bike helmets. But it's got more protection on the temple area here and down behind the ear. And that thickness is what makes it more protective in terms of being good for 28 miles an hour, e-bike class 3. So this is the helmet that I wear like most of the time when I'm riding my e-bike or when I'm riding my e-scooter. My e-scooter, I'm generally traveling between say 20 and 30 miles an hour. So this is perfectly, protective for that. Although my e-scooter can go up to like 50 miles an hour, I'm generally only going that fast in bursts. I'm not really making a big practice of going above 30 miles an hour. I do have to say, however, that if you have a PEV vehicle and you're regularly going above 30 miles an hour, you are really more safe wearing a full motorcycle helmet. So that's something to consider, full DOT approved motorcycle helmet, although that's not always practical because those helmets are, they tend to be like really big and bulky and stuff like that. But for general e-biking and e-scootering, this is my helmet of choice. I really like it. Again, it's made by Xnito. They've only been on the market for maybe about a year. They're kind of a fairly new company. But one of the great things about this Xnito helmet is it comes in many different colors and designs, but also they have a guarantee at where they will replace the helmet for you if you get a crash and you damage the helmet. So they'll completely replace it for you for free. So that's really nice. It's also like really light and comfortable to wear, and the strap is magnetic, so it just kind of flips on and off really easily like that. And so yeah, I'm really impressed with the Xnito helmet, especially for the fact that if you ride in dim lighting conditions at dusk or at night, it's got the built-in lights, which is really nice. Now this built-in headlight is not really meant for you to be able to see at night. It doesn't work like as a headlight for you to see that well. It doesn't like light up the trail or anything like that. It's for other people to see you, like cars and stuff. And in my experience, they can see you really well with this because it's up at their eye level, where your head is, and they can, see you really well. So it's got really good visibility for that. Also, if you want to, you can put more reflectors like on the sides of this helmet as well. They'll stick on perfectly fine for even added safety. But I've been really impressed with the company philosophy of Xneeto and the fact that they have come out with this helmet specifically for Class 3 e-biking and also e-scootering and e-skating and things like that. So check the link in the description field. I will put an affiliate link for where you can get this for a really good price on Amazon. Let me go ahead and turn it off here. Also, in terms of the lights, they say that once it's fully charged, it's rated for about 10 hours, so it can last 10 hours. And I think it takes like 2 hours to charge or something like that with a USB-C port. Now, the other kind of helmet that a lot of people tend to like is a full face helmet, and I have one by Rurock here. Let me show you that. All right, so this is another helmet that a lot of people like. As you can see, it's a full face helmet. It's by Rurock, and this is the RG1DX. This is technically a snowboarding and skiing helmet, so it's a downhill helmet. It's not really certified for things like e-scootering or e-bikes, although a lot of people tend to use it for that because it just looks so cool. It's a full face helmet, and you know, this faceplate comes off and all that, and the visor of course comes off. So this is a really cool helmet as well, but again, it's not certified for e-biking, e-skating, or things like that. It's more of a downhill helmet, although it does offer, I would say, probably the equivalent of protection as the Xneeto helmet. Although they don't technically certify it for that. It does have some special protection inside, which they call Rheon, R-H-E-O-N. And it's kind of like impact protection on the other side of the helmet. They're like these little stubby things where if there's an impact, they will turn into a solid to protect your skull and your brain inside there. So this is another option. You know, a lot of people like this because it just looks so cool. I myself, when I'm riding my e-scooter, I will sometimes wear this if I am going to be going on kind of a longer trip, or maybe I'm going to be going a little bit faster, or I'm going to be going amongst traffic. I kind of maybe feel a little bit more comfortable having a full face helmet because this does have the face protection with this sort of this faceplate here. Now the faceplate isn't as certified as the actual helmet, so it's not as protective, but they have done some tests, Rurock has, and they have showed that this faceplate is, you know, pretty strong. So it does provide some protection. So I kind of switch it off between this helmet and the Xneeto helmet. But one of the things about having the Xneeto helmet is if you're just riding on pathways with pedestrians and bicyclists and stuff like that, it's kind of nice to be able to stop and talk to people or stuff like that. It's just a little bit more friendly. You can hear more with that helmet. You can talk to people easier with that helmet. Whereas a full face helmet like this, you can't really easily stop and talk to people. I mean, you can, but it's just not as friendly. They don't, you know, just they kind of don't acknowledge you as easily. They won't recognize you, and you don't hear them as well and stuff like that. The other thing about this helmet is the peripheral vision isn't quite as good. I mean, it's not bad. You can see pretty far wide, but it's not as good as having something like the Xneeto helmet where your face isn't covered. I will say on the Rurock helmets, if you're interested in a Rurock helmet, they tend to have sales at the end of the season. So right around like April, May, they tend to have clearance sales. I picked this helmet up for like $105, which I thought was quite a steal, because the normal price on this helmet is something like $350 or something like that. So definitely if you're interested in a Rurock helmet, look for the sales. And then also they have tons of different designs, you know, airbrush designs, you know, with cool looks and stuff like that. I just wanted something basic. But I also do ski as well, so I use this for skiing and stuff like that. So it's a really cool helmet when I want a full face helmet. But for ease of use, it's the Xneeto helmet for me most of the time, just for like short e-scoot trips and e-bike trips. You know, the full face Rurock tends to be a little bit more of a commitment to take on and off. It takes longer, you know, to put on and off, whereas this helmet I can just throw on super easily in just a minute or two and I'm good to go. Also, this is much lighter and a little bit more comfortable to wear and stuff like that. And also, if I want to wear my eyeglasses, this tends to work a little bit better too, although I can fit my eyeglasses on the Rurock helmet as well. This is just generally a little bit more easier to wear in general. The other thing to note in terms of this video is the angle on my camera here is pretty wide, so it's kind of accentuating how big these are when I hold them up to the camera. I think in real life, I should be holding them closer down here. They're not really that big looking. So that's just something to note. So again, if you have like a really fast e-scooter or one of those new e-bikes that are super powerful that go really fast, like above 30 miles an hour, you know, a lot of the e-bikes coming out now are almost like electronic motorcycles, and they can actually go up to 60 miles an hour. In those situations, you definitely want to get a full motorcycle helmet, not any of the helmets I've shown in this video. But if you're typically cruising around at, say, between maybe 20 and 35, 40, with an average of like 20, 25, something like this Xnito Class 3 e-bike helmet is certified for 28. The other thing I forgot to mention is this Xnito helmet is certified under the Dutch standard. I believe it starts with like NTA. So it is Class 3 e-bike certified, and so it's a pretty good helmet for that. Again, see my link in the description field. So if you have any questions, comments, or feedback, I'd love to hear them. And if you have a favorite helmet, I'd love to hear what your favorite helmet is in the comments field. Be safe out there on your PEV, everyone, and I'll see you in my next video.